Oh, hi there. Welcome to the laboratory for the scientific rankings of the 16 personalities. As you can tell from my coat and glasses, I am a scientist. Productivity, that's what we're talking about today. How productive are each of the 16 personalities? We're gonna rank them from most productive to least productive. If we could get real for a second, anyone of any type could be productive or not productive, but there are certain qualities of each personality type that either set you up for success in the arena of productivity or maybe could present some difficulties for you. So we'll go through each of the 16 Myers-Briggs personalities. I'll tell you a few things about each of them in terms of how they might be productive or maybe how they might not be as productive. And then for each type, I'll give you a tip for being even more productive. First up, theoretically, according to this list, the most productive personality type is gonna be the ESTJ. ESTJs are very organized. They really know how to rely on others to get work done and like spread the work around. And they are practical and detail focused. They're not gonna get, you know, lost in the weeds of what are the possibilities of what to do here. My tip for ESTJs might sound counterintuitive, but take some time for self-care. ESTJs have a hard time turning off their work brain. They just wanna work, 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 work. Please don't copyright strike me. So ESTJs need to consciously and purposefully say, I am stopping now, I am going to relax and not think about work. Number two, we have the ENTJ. ENTJs know how to delegate. They're not gonna just like put all the work on their own shoulders. They also like to go into a task with a plan. They know how they're gonna attack it. They know how to get it done the fastest way possible. And that brings us to the third thing. They're very efficient. ENTJs don't like to grind. They don't like to get caught up in the details. They're like, how can I just get this done as fast as I can? My pro tip, and by pro, I mean productivity, for the ENTJs is when you're in your working environment, you're at your office, your home office, don't just focus purely on the efficiency. Don't just be in a totally utilitarian Soviet style office. Try to put a little splash of beauty in there. Maybe you have a nice picture on the wall or like a flower on your desk, or you play some music you like as you're working. Just a little bit of beauty can go a long way. Number three on the list, the ISTJ. ISTJs are very structured and very task oriented. They're just like, what's we gotta get done? Let's get it done. And they're realistic. They're not gonna bite off more than they can chew. They know how to be like, realistically, I can get these two things done today, and that's what I'm gonna focus in on. Unlike some other types, intuitives, who will be like, I can get 45 things done today, and then they get nothing done. But Frank, you just ranked the ENTJ higher. I know. I didn't say this was entirely consistent. My tip for the ISTJs is to take a few minutes every day to think outside the box. Do some brainstorming, think up some wild and crazy ideas. You don't have to use them, but it's good to just kind of do a little bit of mental exercises so that you might one day be like, oh, actually that weird idea I had, there was something to that. Number four on the list is the INTJ. INTJs are systems oriented so that they can get things done fast without having to get caught up in the details, in the sensory world. Just like the ENTJ, but even more so, INTJs don't wanna grind. They don't wanna be like doing stupid small little things. They wanna figure out how can I set up a system that will then let me bypass that. But in some ways, INTJs will spend a lot of time seemingly not doing work, but they're really just like getting a system in place so that then they can go into hyperdrive and just get a bunch of stuff done really fast. My tip for INTJs is to write down everything you do so that when you have to go back, you don't have to struggle again with the details. Something simple like, oh, these are the pens that I really like to use to write with. Where did I buy them? What are they specifically? How do I get them again? Just writing that down so when you need pens again, you can be like, okay, this is what I do. that can be a tremendous time saver. Frank, that was such a boring tip. Yeah, you know what? Some types have more mundane, boring problems than other types do. Number five on the list is the ISFJ. ISFJs want to be helpful, so they will especially be productive when it will help someone else. They are good communicators. They have the facts and they're able to communicate it to you in a way that gets across what's important. And they are good at prioritizing tasks. And my tip for the ISFJs would be at the end of the day and throughout the day as you are doing things, congratulate yourself on what you get right throughout the day, what you're accomplishing. Because, you know, the ISFJs, surprisingly, can be very hard on themselves and they just focus in, they won't say it to you, but they'll just inwardly focus on all the stuff that they did wrong or all the stuff that they didn't accomplish. So for the ISFJs out there, give yourself some applause for the things that you accomplish. Number six is the ESFJ. ESFJs are great team players, which can help with productivity when they're feeding off of the feedback from others. ESFJs, very detail-oriented, and they are responsible, especially when other people are expecting things of them. But here's my tip for the ESFJs. Don't wait around to get approval from other people before you take action, because the ESFJs will do this thing. You guys will be like, well, I think I should do this. This seems like something that will accomplish what we're trying to accomplish here, but is that good? Is that right? Do you guys like that? You gotta like pull back from that and just be like, okay, it's all on me. I'm gonna take action without consulting other people. Let's go. Let's do this thing. The number seven most productive type, ISTP. ISTP is very smart and they're very good at handling changing situations. You know, if there's some new information that comes in and they're like, oh crap, we have to rethink how we're approaching this problem. They're like, okay, no problem. I got it. I've figured out how to incorporate this into what we're doing and we're good to go. They're also very, very independent. They're good at working on their own. I mean, not just good at working on their own, that's really the only way that they want to work. So that's my tip for the ISTPs to really increase your productivity is to allow others to assist you. A lot of times they don't want to involve other people. It's like my tasks, my productivity is all on me. I got to do it myself. So if you open up a little bit and you're like, okay, let me let other people help me out, I think it will definitely help your productivity. Although all the ISTPs are like, no, it won't. It'll make things worse. They're just like, no, no. So I don't even know why I bother giving you the tip. ESTPs are coming in hot at number eight. They are not afraid of taking bold action. They're like, I see a shot, I'm taking it. They're also just good at making stuff up as they go. Just being like, okay, in the moment, what should I do now to get this thing done? Okay, let's do that. And they are competitive. So if you put them in a situation where they are trying to be more productive than someone else, like if they're in sales, they might wanna be more productive, get the higher sales number than other people at the company because they are so competitive. So for the ESTP, here's your boring tip. start planning your day out so you don't get sidetracked. Like that's the big thing for ESTPs. They don't want to plan and they just kind of want to go with whatever seems interesting in the moment. And the problem is you could get so sidetracked that you never actually fully accomplish anything. Okay, now let's take a momentary break and when we come back, we'll go with the second half of the list. The lower half of the productivity of the, I forgot how to formulate a sentence. Anyway, I'll just see you there. Welcome back, people. Okay, coming in at number nine, the ninth most productive Myers-Briggs personality, I would say is the ENFJ. ENFJs are great at prioritizing and being like, here are the tasks that are most important down to the least important. They really love to focus on how they can improve things for the group, for everyone else. So if what they are trying to accomplish, if the productivity is related to that, then they can be very productive. And they are great at building up other people when they're on a team. Here's my tip for the ENFJs. I don't know why I did a fist there like I'm gonna punch you, but focus on getting your tasks done. You have your list of stuff that you want to accomplish. Focus on that. Even if other people come over and say, hey, actually, could you help me with this? Could you do this? Could you do that? ENFJs are so quick to drop what they are doing because they want to help other people that can really hamper their own productivity. You got to learn to be like, yeah, sorry, I'm doing my own thing. And then once you get your stuff done, then you can help the other people. Number 10 on the list is the INTP. Some of you might be shocked at how high on the list the INTP is, since they stereotypically get this rap for being lazy. However, they are very oriented towards problem solving, and they get laser focused in on what they want to do. They are good at thinking up many possible outcomes for any particular action. However, as you might have detected from this list of strengths when it comes to productivity, that doesn't necessarily mean they're gonna do anything. The INTP has really gotta find a problem they wanna solve and go after that. Now, my tip for the INTPs, which will help with like doing that, stepping out and actually taking action, is take time to prioritize what is important to accomplish. I think a lot of times they just prefer to sit back and just look at the possibilities. This question of asking what is the most important, what are the priorities, that's actually feeling. So that's what you gotta do to become more productive, is to tap into the feeling side and prioritize. The number 11 type most productive on this list is the ENTP. ENTPs love a challenge. You know, when you meet a bandit in Skyrim and they go, I love a challenge. Those bandits in Skyrim are ENTPs. They're always driven to find alternative ways of doing things. They hate being stuck with just one option. And ENTPs will listen to others' opinions, even if they end up finding out that they're dumb. And that's good, because ENTPs aren't just gonna shut other people down. They wanna listen, they wanna hear, are they saying something that could work, that could increase my productivity? Let me see. They won't accept everything that people tell them, but they will listen. My tip for the ENTPs, which is going to enrage you, is clean your office. Make sure your desk is cleaned off. Get stuff organized. Figure out, oh, here's my highlighter. Where does this live? Where am I gonna store this every day? Get your space clean, get your mind clean. That sounded weird, but yeah, I'm going with it. The number 12 most productive personality type is the ESFP. ESFPs work well in fast-paced environments. ESFPs are focused on realities, not possibilities. So ESFPs are just like, what's right in front of us? What do we have to do right here, right now? And ESFPs are good at evaluating things and giving constructive feedback to others, which can be helpful in a group setting. My tip for the ESFPs is to work smarter, not harder. Take a page out of the INTJ's playbook. Take some time to think of ways where you could possibly streamline your work, where you can come up with some kind of system so that instead of having to grind through all of the details all the time, you are going with an efficient process and getting your work done faster, getting more things done. The number 13 on the list is the ISFP. ISFPs are passionate and full of emotion, which could help with productivity, but it might not. It depends. Are they working on what they're passionate about or not? ISFPs are curious and they love to explore and try new things, which can be a great way of getting things done, because they like to just kind of jump in and mess around and be like, okay, well, let's see what we can come up with here. And ISFPs can handle changing environments. They don't get freaked out when there is some new way of doing things. My tip for the ISFPs is to be more of a team player and learn to kind of accept criticism. The ISFPs are very independent. They don't really want to be on a team. And when people criticize them, they either take it as being like an attack, or they just tune it out and don't even let it register. So it's important for the ISFPs to realize your productivity can increase when you tap into the criticism, when you're like, okay, they're actually showing me maybe a better way that I could do things. Next up is the INFP. The INFPs are creative and visionary, and they're very aware of what's important to them. See, that's the thing. Not everyone is aware of what's important. But the INFPs are like, I know what's important. And if their work can line up with that, they can be very productive. They're also very strong-willed. So all of these things could go either way. Those attributes could set them up to be super productive in a way that no one else is. It could also set them up to not accomplish much because they haven't figured out how to get themselves aligned so that they are working towards those things that they think are important and those things that they really want to do. And so my tip for the INFPs is to just start getting stuff done, even if you don't feel like it. If you want to accomplish something, there's this great thing that you really care about, there are going to be steps along the way that don't necessarily seem important, don't seem fun, don't seem like something that you actually want to do, you're not excited about it, but you still got to do those things to get where you want to be. The number 15 spot, we're going to go with the INFJs. INFJs are good at planning, looking long term, seeing what's going to happen 10 steps down the road. They are creative, abstract thinkers. They'll usually approach a problem way different than everyone else in the room. And in a group, they know how to foster a good working environment. They realize like what's going to get everyone's spirits up, what's going to get them to be more productive. Maybe not necessarily helping themselves out, but from a group perspective, it will help productivity. The INFJs can get held up with just thinking about stuff and just, you know, planning, just thinking about things abstractly, just thinking about, oh, that would be good, this would be better, oh, here's some cool stuff that could happen, and then they don't want to do it because they don't like to get into the real sensory world. And, you know, I've made a ton of videos about INFJs, and you can look through the playlist here in the card above my head. Whoa! INFJs, my tip for you to be more productive is stop planning. You want to keep planning, you want to figure out how can I make sure this is perfect, how can I make sure this is executed with no hitches. You gotta cut it off at some point. Stop planning, get messy, get it done. Don't even hold on to a hope that it's going to be perfect because it won't be. And then this number 16, what I have determined to be scientifically the least productive personality type is the ENFP. ENFPs are driven by inspiration. And of course, the problem is inspiration, you know, comes in fits and starts. It's not something that's there all the time. It's not a sustainable thing. ENFPs think big and they think wild and they think crazy. So, in other words, very creative, but not always practical. And they are good at taking in alternative viewpoints from other people. Here's my tip for the ENFP. Stick to things until you get results. ENFPs like to start things and then think up something better that they like more and then drop that project and go on to the next one. You gotta stop doing that. It's because they're following the inspiration. You gotta realize inspiration comes for a little bit and then it goes away and then it's just work, you know? So to be productive and to actually accomplish some stuff, you gotta stick to it even once the fire of the inspiration has gone. You need to create and manufacture your own inspiration and keep yourself going until you have seen in the outside world some results. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out my sponsor, Grammarly, at the link down below. Watch another video right here about something. How do the personality types develop over time? That's right here. Or if you want to pick another video out of the playlist, you can watch it right here. Thanks for watching. Until next time, stay cool and attractive.